Hi, I'm Kate Muller, an application specialist with Agilent Technologies. In an earlier video, we introduced the concept of envelope tracking and covered how to generate test signals for envelope tracking devices. In this video, I'm going to show how to analyze both the RF and the envelope signals, measuring the effects of envelope tracking on power amplifier distortion and efficiency. First, let's take a look at the demo setup. Here I have an envelope tracking power amplifier and power supply that I'm going to use as my device under test. The MXG signal generator is providing the RF input signal to the power amplifier. The 33522B arbitrary waveform generator is providing the envelope signal to the envelope tracking power supply. If you want to see more on how to generate these test signals, watch our previous video on envelope tracking. For analyzing the performance of our envelope tracking power amplifier, we're using an Agilent 90,000 series oscilloscope. It has plenty of bandwidth for this application, and having four channels makes it easy to analyze multiple signals at once. If you need better dynamic range, Agilent's X-Series signal analyzers with baseband IQ inputs can also be used. Here I'm using three channels of my scope to acquire the PA's RF input signal, RF output signal, and the baseband envelope signal. Now let's take a look at how to analyze these using the 89600 VSA software. Let's start with some typical power amplifier measurements with a constant supply voltage, so no envelope tracking. We're looking at the power amplifier input and output signal spectrum and time traces. We've set up an ACP measurement to see how much of the channel distortion is present at the output of the PA. We can also characterize distortion with measurements like AM to AM, AM to PM, and gain compression to understand the overall performance of the power amplifier. Now let's turn on envelope tracking and take a look at the impact on the power amplifier performance. With the shaping table we've used on the envelope signal, we can see that we've been able to decrease the ACPR and linearize the gain of the power amplifier. Adding another measurement to the 89600 VSA software lets us look at the envelope signal simultaneously and verify the shaping that's been applied to the envelope. The VSA software also calculates the timing delay between the RF and envelope signals. We can use additional tools in the 89600 VSA software to investigate unexpected signal results. The stimulus and response time traces allow us to compare the time-aligned input and output signals of the PA, while the delta EVM versus time trace shows the error between the two signals over time. By coupling markers, we can pinpoint and analyze the unexpected behavior in all the different trace views. One of the key benefits of envelope tracking is improved efficiency. By using the oscilloscope to look at the voltage and current signals in the envelope tracking power supply, we can also calculate and display the power added efficiency in the 89600 VSA software. This allows us to analyze the efficiency improvement we get by using envelope tracking instead of a fixed supply. In this short video, we looked at analyzing envelope tracking power amplifiers and power supplies using the Infinium oscilloscope and the 89600 VSA software. Get a free 30-day trial of the 89600 VSA software to use with your Agilent hardware at the URL shown here. Thanks for watching.